Before we talk about how we can implement RVM efficiently with a battery-backed DRAM, let's first understand how we can use a battery-backed DRAM to implement a persistent file cache. What we mean by that is, typically file systems use a file cache to hold data that it has brought from the disk for efficiency of manipulation by programs running on the processor. And when we say it's a persistent file cache, what we are saying is even if there is power failure, the contents of this file cache is still available when the power comes back up again. And in order to achieve that, what we're going to do is we're going to string a UPS power supply to back this file cache, which is implemented in DRAM. So the contents of the file cache never goes away. And we will also postulate that there is VM, a virtual memory protection, that has been built in to the operating system to prevent operating system errors such as wild writes to the file cache during software crash or power failure. Now, there are two ways to use the RIO file cache. One is when a process does file writes, actually they're writing to the in-memory copy of the file. Typically, operating systems buffer the writes that you do to files in DRAM and then write them out to the disk at opportune moments later on. And now, if these file writes go to this file cache, which is battery-backed, then you make sure that these file writes are persisted. Normally, if an application wants to make sure that when it writes a file, the contents of the file is immediately forced to disk, the application would have to do an fsync call in a Unix system, for instance. But if we have this battery-backed file cache, the application can simply do normal file writes and don't worry about doing an fsync because writing to the file writes to the file cache and the file cache is persistent by definition because it is battery-backed. And similarly, another common operation that is done is Unix allows files to be mmapped, that is mapped into memory. And if an application maps a file into memory and writes to that file using normal program writes, those normal program writes become persistent because these writes are backed by the file cache and the file cache is battery backed. And therefore, normal program writes becomes persistent also. So with the RIO file cache that is battery backed, what we get is that file writes by a process as well as normal program writes to memory mapped files become persistent by definition. In the absence of this facility of a persistent file cache, if an application were to mmap a file and write to that using normal program writes, then it will have to do what is called an msync call in order to make sure that writes that it did to virtual memory actually get persisted on the disk. But with a file cache, RIO file cache that is persistent, there is no need to do that because by definition, we are saying any writes that get into this file cache will persist. In other words, the contents of this file cache will survive power failures. So if there is a system crash, whether it is a power failure or software crash, the file cache data in memory is going to be written out to the disk for recovery. And so the upshot is, no synchronous writes are needed to the disk anymore. And it also means that write-back of files written to by an application can be arbitrarily delayed. What that means from the file system perspective is that if the lifetime of files is very short, then those files go away. And so you don't have to write it to the disk in the first place. And this is common in a compilation process, for instance. There are a number of temporary files that are created, and those files live in the file cache for a short amount of time, and when the compilation process is complete, those files will be deleted, so you never have to write those files to the disk. So that's a good thing about having this idea of a persistent file cache. Now let's look at how we can use RIO to implement RVM. So we've got this persistent file cache, and we're going to ask the question, if we have this persistent file cache, how can we optimize the implementation of a reliable virtual memory?